music that parents love to hate.
When you put our record on, you feel like you're close to us. You feel like you know us. You know, we're wide open. We know fun.
Schoolie D is the perfect gangster from America. Cars, guns, drugs, women.
They think rappers are tough. That's what they expect. And they say, I don't look tough.
It's sending a message out to people, really. It's saying that, well, this is how it is, and, you know, this is where I come from.
Philly's type sound is more up-tempo, like, maybe more up-tempo, more type of sound that to make you want to get on the floor and dance.
Rap City is brought to you by the TV 12 subscribers.
Sheba, Sheba, on my brain. Went downtown, jumped a train. 12 o'clock, I'm in New York. No cab, had to walk. Downtown, Latin Quarter, sky inside. Drunk some water, step on stage. Started to talk, I say, yo, yo, what up, New York? Dance all around, act real silly. Homie in the crowd said I must be from Philly.
Some people tell you that rap started in Jamaica. Some people will tell you that it started out in the discotheques in the Bronx back in the 70s. Somebody gives credit to Jaco Henderson, who is the father of a DJ here on local radio.
And instead of just introducing records, you know, we used to rhyme and rap. It's a hello, 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 back with the show. This is your engineer, Jaco E. Tiddlyock. Ho, this is Jock, and I'm back on the scene with the record machine saying goof pop do. How do you do? I don't know who originated the word rap, but that came a little bit later. But we just called it rhythm talk. Talking in rhythm, you know?
I can't believe it, I just made a mistake. Well, parents are the same no matter time or place. So to you other kids all across the land, take it from me, parents just don't understand.
A lot of people, like my parents, they think that rap is what like you're doing. They're telling you to do drugs up out of high school, but on the contrary, it's not like that.
Sometimes if my mom would tell me something, and I might not like what she say, but if my girlfriend was to tell me something, I probably would wind up listening to my girlfriend if it's something that's really happening in the street.
Most people over the rappers' ages do not comprehend what they're saying because they do not take their time or the beat over it excels the words.
They should listen to the record, because if they listen to the record, it would tell them what's involved in their kids' lives the minute they stepped out the door and walked down the porch and walked down the street, to the pool hall, to the bar.
It's kind of the 80s answer to the 60s heavy metal, you know, like against the society type deal.
Rap is a sort of rebellious kind of an art form. It's different, and it's a little attitude-y and kind of angry sounding, and I think this is for the kids of this, you know, generation.
Street beat on a Friday night as we salute Philadelphia rap artists. These next brothers I'm getting ready to play, we should be very, 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 very proud of them. They are two majors. They're on MTV. As a matter of fact, they were up for an MTV award. Philadelphia's own Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince, they've been all across the world. They're a big unit here in Philadelphia. We love you. We're real proud of you. And keep up the good work.
Are you all ready?
Automatically, when people hear rap, they get a sour taste in their mouth. Yeah, you know, for some reason, rap has a bad connotation. Certain rap groups, certain times, have done things wrong. Certain people have done things wrong. I mean, how can you just say, okay, rap is bad? I hate rap. You know, I don't think that people should do that, and I don't think anyone should be subject to have to live down that stereotype like we're having to.
So much of our audience are young urban teenagers, and they're stereotyped. I mean, if you wear sneakers, if you wear gold chains, then you're automatically a drug dealer, you're automatically, you know, a drug addict. And there are a lot of kids that are bitter, you know, that want to be heard, and they use rap as a vehicle. But there are a lot of kids who want to be funny.
Hey, Ray, hold on. What? I think I want to change the show just a little bit. While I was talking about something. Jeff, can I just, want to change it a little bit.
Do you tell me, what do you want?
Hold on, Ray. I just want to play a quick game of Donkey Kong.
In a time where rappers wanted to be hard and grabbing themselves and all that kind of stuff, we chose to come out and make people laugh.
All right.
They talk about pretty much how it was for them living in Winfield, you know, going to school, hanging out, going to parties, meeting girls, stuff like that. In Winfield, you know, it's a nice, quiet neighborhood. You can have your fun whenever you want to. You know, it's a nice place to live. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of pretty girls out here, too.
Some people have a statement about society in their rap. Some people have a statement about themselves. And their statement is just overall for everybody, you know.
Okay. Here's the situation. My parents went away on a week's vacation and they left the keys to the brand new Porsche. Well, they mine? Well, of course not.
Well, he has high values, so he can pretty much take care of himself. You know, I just worry about him eating right. That's all.
Which he doesn't usually, even when he's at home.
My parents had to come off a vacation to get me. I'd rather be in jail than to have my father hit me. My parents walked through and I got my grandpa said, Mom, Dad, how was your trip?
I went straight from toys to being a DJ, so I really wasn't, you know, hanging with the guys. You know, used to tease me, Jeff gonna get married, he's gonna marry an album and have 45 for kids, you know. nowadays, they're like, Jeff, make me a tape, or when's your next show, you know.
Excuse me, Jeff, can I have a dollar, please?
Yeah.
In the hip-hop culture, a lot of people feel that they have to have this fancy car and they have to have this gold and all that kind of stuff. We're not like that. We want people to see that we're ourselves.
If I was Franklin Stone, I'd probably own all of Bedrock. If I was a criminal, I'd probably own a cell block. If I was in the Navy, I would own the sea. But I'm a poet, so I own the whole rap industry.
I believe in corporate America, just like anything else. They believe, and their theory is, if you can't beat it or you can't, you know, you either destroy it or you buy it. And I think they couldn't destroy hip-hop, so they brought it.
We'd like to thank you for buying the album. We'd like to ask you to continue buying them, continue coming to the shows. Thank you very much. We love you.
Peace.
The revolution will not be televised, not be televised, will not be televised. The revolution will not be televised. We cannot have a revolution because there are no revolutionaries, brother. We will not be able to get Bill Cosby black ass off NBC and move his black ass back to the ghetto. We'll not be able to convince him to come in and use America's new nigga.
They just can't believe some of the stuff I said. You know, it's like everybody wants to say it, but nobody's gonna say it, so they depend on school to be to say it.
A lot of raps now are like giving political messages, which is kind of good, which is and interesting too, because rap has this quote unquote negative connotation as being like condescending or some heathenous music that only black people do.
Television period shows a negative image of young blacks. So if you watch television, you say from the time you wake up in the morning, come home, the only thing you can think subconsciously that all of them is criminals.
It's ignored by white mainstream media because it is sort of something that's confrontational.
He's known as the gangster of hip-hop, amongst other things. He has a brand new LP called Smoke Some Kill, and we have about two cuts off the LP that we can play on the air.